Hello there. My name's Yvette, and I'll be the nurse that'll be taking some of your preliminary vitals and just do some general testing before the recommendations go over to the doctor and they possibly give you a prescription for medication that would best suit you. I read your preliminary report that you're having a lot of difficulties breathing, you're very congested, and you have a very sore throat. It always seems to be flu season nowadays. Everyone's always sick. Or at least we always seem to know someone that's sick. So what we're suspecting is that you may have something like a respiratory infection, something that's usually bacterial or microbial, something that's usually very treatable with antibiotics, good nourishment, and making sure that your body is allowed the time to rest to heal. Well, we're going to just start with a couple of things. Because this is something that might be contagious or communicable, I'm going to be wearing my mask the entire time, just so that when I'm doing the examination that there's no transfer, or at least limiting the transfer of germs. Okay. Alright. First thing that I'd like to do is I'd like to take your blood pressure and just see whether or not you're at an elevated level. If you're ill, that can happen. Yeah. Okay, do you mind holding up your arm? Thank you. Okay, now just try to relax as best you can. Breathe in. It hurts to breathe in. Okay, we'll get to that. Try your best. Okay. You're a little bit elevated, and your heart rate is also a little bit elevated. It's nothing to be too terribly concerned about, considering that you might be fighting a bacterial infection. When was the last time that you were able to eat anything? Are you having any difficulties with solid foods? Having any difficulties keeping those foods down? Okay. And is it the normal diet that you would maintain regardless of whether or not you're sick? A little bit less? Smoke, and if so, how frequently? How about alcohol consumption? I'd like to take a look inside of your mouth and check your throat. I'm going to be using a tongue presser just to move your cheek to the side and take a look at your gums, also into your throat. Do you mind? Okay. Open up. Okay. please? Do you mind moving your tongue to one side of the mouth? Then to the other? Do you feel like you have any sores or anything like that developing on your gums? No sore spots, any teeth, anything like that? One of the things that is often experienced with a very severe sinus infection would be something like your front teeth almost hurting. And a lot of the times what that is if you have a buildup in your nasal cavities, it can actually cause pressure, which can cause your teeth. That's actually quite common. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'd like to check your lymph glands, see if they're swollen. So with your permission, I'd like to place my hands along the side of your neck and just kind of palpitate all the way down into your chest and see whether or not that causes any reactions, but also to feel for any type of swelling or any kind of obstructions that might be in those glands. Is that okay? Okay. And now if this hurts, this can sometimes be uncomfortable, but if it hurts, let me know. Sinuses right here. Does this feel tender? I can see your eyes are distressed quite a bit as well. About like on the forehead. Your nose. Is that okay? Thank you. Have you ever had any piercings in your nose? Listen to your lungs and to your heart. Okay, I'm going to start high up on your chest here. Take a deep breath in for me. It hurts. I'm sorry. Yeah, it does sound like you have quite a bit of congestion. Go ahead and try breathing in again, as deep as you can. Again. And again. A couple more times. reach around to your back so I can place this on the back. Is that okay? Thank you. Breathe in for me. One more for me. I'm going to place this on your chest in specific spots so that we can listen to your heart rate and listen to each of the chambers. Okay, so I'm going to start here on the top. Do you mind lifting up your left arm just a little bit so that I can come in here from your left side? Okay. You can just breathe normally. Stretches out your breast a little bit here and your pec muscles so I can get a little bit closer to that bottom chamber. Lungs do indeed sound very, very congested. So I'm going to make a note on there, and I think that the doctor is probably going to prescribe you antibacterial or an antibiotic in the meantime to help your immune system get a grip on this. But we're also going to take some samples of the mucus that is coming out of your mouth and also out of your eyes, and that way we can test to make sure if it's microbial, if it is a certain strand of microbe, if it is viral. That way we can treat you the most appropriate way, okay? Okay, let me just take a couple of quick notes. Have you been coughing a lot lately? Is it a productive cough or is it a dry cough? Okay. And what kind of remedies, or have you not tried any? Okay. Has it alleviated the symptoms at all? Heart rate. I'd like to take some samples of the fluid coming out of your eyes and also coming out of your nose. It's maybe not the most pleasant experience, but if we can send these samples off and have them tested, we'll be able to treat you much more effectively. Okay. Do you mind lifting your head up just a little bit so I can see your nose? This might tickle just a little bit. I'm going to go into your right nostril. Sorry. Just put that on a slide. Now we're going to get a new one. Okay, now pull up for me. Okay. nice sample. What I'm going to have you do is I'm going to have you look off to one direction, and I'm just going to very quickly scoop some of that fluid out of your tear duct. Okay. I want you to look over to the side, okay? Direction. Okay. Go ahead and blink a couple of times. It's not always that pleasant, I know. I'd like to get a closer look at your eyes. Since you do have some discharge that's coming out, I want to see if there's any obvious signs of infection, the color of the fluid that's coming out, whether or not it is opaque or transparent. So I'm going to get a little bit close to you. I'm going to use one of my fingers to hold your eyelid open so I can look at the back of your eye. Is that all right? Following the light. Okay. Was that difficult? More difficult than normal? Take a look into your ears, if that's okay. I'm going to start on the side and use my otoscope. Just try to hold still for me. If I pull up on your ear here, does this hurt? I can actually see some discharge, some abnormally colored discharge in that ear. Let me switch out my head. I'm gonna check again on this side. Now, if I pull up on your ear, does this? I think it would be a very good idea to try to flush out your ears a little bit because you do have a lot of yellow discharge. It could be a result of the bacterial infection, but if we can help to drag that material out, not only will it make you feel better, but it'll relieve some of the pressure that you're experiencing in your head. Okay. Alright. You doing okay? First thing that I'm probably going to do with the ears is to try and irrigate it. I'll take some distilled water and just kind of pour it into the ear. It'll be a nice stream of water, but I'll have a cup underneath your ear to catch all of that water as it comes out. Okay. It's lukewarm, so it shouldn't be a shock. Let's start with this here. You ready? Feeling okay? You want to try it again? The more we do this, the easier it will be to clear out, okay? Alright, here it comes. Quite a bit more. Sit, kind of moisten the area up, kind of break that fluid down as well, while I move on to the other ear, and then manually extract some of that debris, okay? Okay, you ready? Here it comes. I'm gonna tug up on your ear a little bit, okay? Dizzy. That actually happens a lot. The reason why we feel dizzy when we get our ears cleaned, or if our ears have been stuffy, is because the pressure in our ear actually obstructs the fluid from moving in our ear canal, and that's what our brain uses a lot of the times to help us determine balance. So when we make that pressure uneven, or if we alter it, us feel very dizzy. Just let me know if you need a break, okay? Alright. If you're ready, we're gonna do this one more time, okay? I can tell you that that's going to definitely help. Some tweezers. I'm very gentle in how I do this, but I'm just going to try to grab material, slowly drag it out. Is that okay? Alright. Thank goodness it's windy out there today. Take a cotton swab. Also get a sample of this for analysis as well. Okay. Just gonna very gently spin this in your ear. It tickles, I'm sorry. Slide. other ear is also softened up a bit. We're going to work on that side. Is that okay? Actually hard, which makes me think that it's bacterial. If it's just wax, wax will stay in a very mushy consistency. This is more of like a caked on dryer residue. Doing good. Just a little bit more. Fantastic. Take a sample with cotton swab. Assuming that this is bacterial, we're gonna do two more things. I'd like to reach inside of your mouth and just with my fingertips run across to your gums, along your cheek, and to see if you have any kind of abscesses, any kind of lesions that we need to be concerned of, or a reaction to something else. Okay. Is it okay? I'm gonna, if I cause you to gag, or if you need a moment, just put your hands up. Let me know and I'll back away, okay? Alright. I'm just gonna rub my hand along. Go ahead and open up your mouth for me. On the outside of your cheek. On your gums. Okay, in the front here. I know if I push on your teeth, this does hurt. Not hurt, but it aches a little bit. Okay. I think that's due to a sinus infection. Okay. On your gum. Is it okay if I slide my fingers under your tongue? Along your teeth. Okay. Okay. The next part is at least going to be a little bit more fun. I'm going to take some medicated menthol rub. I'm going to use this especially on this area right here. Give you a little bit of chest palpitations, but What we're really aiming for is to stimulate the lymphatic system to engage, and that way it can hopefully move a lot of this fluid quicker to your organs and then process whatever illness. It definitely helps with a little bit more of a natural healing, and it'll give you quite a bit of a jump before the antibiotics kick in. This portion I'm not going to be using gloves for because it's a medicated cream. It's a balm. And this will be the last part of the exam. Okay. Is it okay if I touch these areas of your neck, chest, and maybe even into your eyebrows? Chest. Take my two fingers and I'm going to tap on your chest here. Let me know if this hurts, if it's uncomfortable, or if it causes you to feel the urge to sneeze. Rub these areas here, okay? Get that fluid moving. It's nice that this can sometimes bring some immediate relief. Yeah. And you can always do these types of exercises at home. What you would normally do is to place your hands usually across from each other and do the palpitations like this, and also drag that fluid down You essentially want to do is to move that fluid from your nasal passages down your neck. Your lymph glands right here, they go all across your chest, but you have a pump underneath your armpits, and you want to be gentle when you do that, but with your hands crossed over your chest, just pump that. It helps to naturally stimulate the body to move the fluid in your lymphatic system and help to get that phlegm down into your organs where it can be processed. So that's what we're going to do here right now. I'm going to start up at your sinuses. Just lightly tap and stroke. Bring that fluid down out of your nose. Do this fast or slow, whatever is comfortable. And bring it back to your sides, right around the base of your ear, down your jaw, down your neck. Towards your armpits. Okay. Is that feeling just a little better? That's always good to hear. Okay. Well, I'm going to pass off this report to the doctor, and he will write you a prescription for some antibiotics to start taking immediately. That will help to get a grip on whatever this infection is. Meanwhile, when the samples that we had taken are analyzed and we know exactly what type of bacterial infection, what strand, or if it's viral, a different way that we can possibly treat it. And then we can prescribe you something that's a little bit more efficient. Alrighty. Well, if you have any emergent or urgent care that you need, feel free to stop on in. In the meantime, I hope that you can get some rest and that you start feeling a little bit better very soon. Okay. Take care. We'll be in touch.